Hello everyone, welcome to this video. My name is Alessandra and I am a digital and ceramic artist. I am making this video to show you my journey of 3D clay printing. As for my last project of university before graduating, I took a filament plastic printer and I modified it to print with clay. So I think it was a really fun process and I wanted to share it with all of you. My first steps were at my uni, as I said. We had a Lutum printer, that was the name of it, if you want to look it up. It was quite old, but it still worked. So I had the chance to look at it and learn from my teacher who taught me like the basics. So I was really glad that I could do this before COVID hit in like hard in my town, because this was a very long process of learning and just preparing the clay takes a long time, especially when you don't know a lot about it. You have to prepare the clay, you have to prepare the machine and then clean everything, like disassemble everything. But thanks to this, I learned this process and I could apply it later to what I made. I learned the basics of using the 3D printer to prepare the 3D files, to know the consistency of the clay, and this helped me to develop later my work. Because what happened is that COVID came and then I couldn't go to university for several months. I think it was like 3 or 4 months that I couldn't go and do anything there. So I was very excited about trying 3D printing with clay, but I didn't have the access to it. So I looked up some printers online and I decided to buy one because they weren't that expensive and I know it was an investment that I could use for my future work. And I am still using my 3D printer today and I'm improving it, so I think it was worth it. So yeah, I got my 3D printer and I knew what I had to do basically to adapt it. I didn't know exactly, but I knew how the other one worked. So what I needed was an effector that will hold the nozzle where the clay will come out. And then I would have a clay container that will contain the clay. And then I will need an air compressor that will push the clay into the clay container, into a tube, and then into the nozzle, and then it will print. It's a very like straightforward process. So I tried with different containers because this is not it's straightforward, you know what you need, but as you go and as you make things, you realize, oh, this is not working, or there's a problem. Where is the problem? I realized that my clay container was too small for the amount of power that my air compressor had. So I had to change it 2 or 3 times until I got a size that was a little bit bigger, so I would need as much air to push the clay more consistently and more quickly. The first trials were really difficult. The clay was sloppy, or sometimes it was too dry. It wouldn't come out of the container and everything will be stuck and I had to start again. So it was a very lengthy process. It was a lot of trial and error. But once you start doing things, you figure out by memory, oh yes, you feel the clay and you say, this needs more water or less water. This clay doesn't work because I tried earthenware. I tried porcelain. And with my printer, it didn't work. With the power that I had with my compressor, it didn't work. So I figured out, oh, I can only use stoneware with this consistency because this is what will work. And then you also need the same consistency every time because it has different drying times. If you want to incorporate it into other objects, you need it to be in a certain level of dryness. So this is all by practice, but I eventually figured out like the consistency that it would need and everything else. the ratios of water and clay. And yeah, as I said, only used stoneware for this project. As you can see here, the shapes got a bit better every time I printed one. So I got into a point where I could print basic shapes that weren't too big because I didn't have that much clay. So I would need to change the clay container every time I will need to print something bigger. And I thought, I can eventually do this, but I need to do something with my project. So I decided I want to print small things, not very tall, because I know this works. So once I got to this point, I decided that I wanted to 3D print elements that I will incorporate to my decorated pieces, as you can see here. So I designed the different elements. In this time there were handles for vessels that I was making. So I designed them and I realized some weren't suitable as I can only print the shell of the handles. So if you have jumps in between the shapes, this wouldn't work because my printer only can print the outside part because it doesn't have a motor that can stop the clay so it doesn't flow out while it's jumping to another point. So that was a bit hard to adapt. But yeah, I could only print the shell of the figures. So yeah, I decided, well, I'm going to do these three shapes that were related to my vessels. I was making vessels that were telling a story about the farmers from the Andes area in South America. So they had to be related to food. So I designed three shapes. First one was their profile of a quinoa plant. So it was very simplified with the time. Second one was the profile of a corn vegetable. And the third one was just a general inspired shape by the potato. So I had my shapes and then I made some trials. I had to figure out what speed I need to use and what flow I need to use so every piece would be consistent in thickness, height, and everything else. So also this is something that takes time, but because my shapes were a bit complex, I decided to print them very slowly and the flow wouldn't be too high. So in my compressor I set the rate to 5 bars, I think, and for my container that wasn't too much, so it was very slow. The speed was slow as well, so that's how I achieved shapes that weren't too distorted, because then when you start getting higher shapes, they will eventually get dragged by the head of the printer, because it gets taller and then the clay is still wet underneath. So I had to be drying every piece while it was printing, as well as having it very slowly printing so it will preserve the shape. So I tried to be consistent on every piece, tried to make it similar to each other because they were two handles for each vessel. And then everything worked out, as you can see, pretty well. I was really happy with the results. The thing is that it worked out after several months, so I spent a long time trying these things. So don't get fooled, because this was a very lengthy and hard work, very lengthy process, a lot of trial and error. And there were lots of shapes that didn't work, and lots of times where I was thinking, oh, this is not going to work because it's handmade. I printed every effector myself. I used the same printer to print them, as well as I designed them. So sometimes I will have problems with the arms of the printer. They won't rotate properly because I had the shapes weren't working fine with the arms. sometimes the clay would come out because there was an irregularity in the printing. So this was all time that I lost, months, weeks. And I can say that it was really long, but it was very worth it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a small introduction to my experience with 3D printers and how I got to make my final pieces for my degree show. And yeah, thank you.